courage to get up here, so keep doing what we're doing. Keep the faith. Well, as usual, I got some shit on my mind, and I'm going to share it with you today. Now, this first piece was compilated from going to every baby daddy that I could find. Not, I don't have any kids. I mean other people, baby. But, because it's about trifling women, and I don't know any personally, so I had to do some serious research for this. Looking for love in all the wrong places, only attracted to long cash and fine faces, raising your dress to every Tom, Dick, and Harry, screwing the world, hoping to get married. When you finally look up and catch you a sucker, you bang his friends, his brother, and even his mother. With your scurvy ways, there's nothing that should pass. When you got pregnant, I thought you'd adopt class. Once again, I was mistaken, and that's really too bad. You allow foreign sperm to hit your baby's head. Are you so addicted to sex that you lack dignity? Whenever you become moist, sex is destiny. You got a down ass brother, and you say he breaks your back, but you take money from him and spend it with Jack. How dare you get irate when a man's had enough? You become all spiteful because he's tired of being soft. So now you hold his seed over his head, telling him if he doesn't abide, their bond will be dead. You swing your ass from rope to rope, tugging every vine, hoping to catch you a dope. A low-down skeezer, carrying diseases, spreading them faster than the word of Jesus. Issued your ass out like commodities, destroying men's private properties. Don't be surprised to get dealt with. One day, you may bounce on the wrong pogo stick. And if your crotch happens to sew itself closed, I guess you'll be back to slobbing knobs, I suppose, with your trifling ass. It's about nosy motherfuckers. And if you can't relate to it, that means you must be one of them. Dig this here, especially to all of you who thought you were a zen. I shall gladly elaborate on exactly what I meant. Frankly, you should shove a fucking rag down your throat. You feel compelled to tattletale on every episode? This message is not subliminal. Actually, it's quite critical. And I want you to take me literally. There are no hidden hyperboles. What it is, and that's how it should be perceived. I see I have to break it down for the busiest of bodies lurking through time. I've said it once and I'll say it again, because some of you obviously didn't comprehend. So I'm willing to put a stank on it. So all you nosy ass people out there can shut the fuck up everywhere and mind your own motherfucking business. You think your casual conversation is substantial as you constantly ramble about the next person's business? You're always the eyewitness of other folks' concerns. Will you ever learn to just shut the fuck up sometimes and capitalize on the opportunity of being seen and not heard? Your prior is so less preferred, way beyond word. So motherfucker, mind your own business. You must be used to playing tag, thinking this shit is a game. Cause every time you utter a sound, it involves someone else's name. Your mouth is bound to write a check when your ass has insufficient cash. You input your fractions to any equation and attempts to catch a few laughs. But your snag remarks are as bold as your ghetto math. You'll find it's not cute walking around snagging tooth. Y'all have to be prone to such episodes. You could choose to keep your damn mouth closed and mind your own motherfucking business. If it don't make dollars, it don't make sense. Spread folks affairs and generate the nip. You're not receiving a check or a credit, no type of compensation, no green persuasion, no neutral funds, no saving bonds, no interest, no dividends, not even a small stipend. But with those zoo slicks that sleep ships, one day you'll get your ass kicked. If you took time to invest in yourself, you wouldn't even bother in other folks' mess. Stop snitching before you get stitches and mind your motherfucking business. You could be canceled, wasted, murdered, crucified, maimed, boosted, mangled,